Hello, my name is Till Papenfuß and this tutorial is for young engineers who suddenly has to do model analysis. So I will explain what the hell is model analysis about. What is a mode shape? This will be in this video. What kind of methods we can use? There's roving accelerometer and roving hammer methods. All will be explained just in basic steps how to do this. And of course, what kind of hammer tips should I use? If I open one of these impulse hammer, what hammer tips is right for my object? All this be done just step by step. This video will give you the chance to say, yes, sir, I can do model analysis, because it's not that difficult as maybe people will make you think, okay? As an example, I always use, this is completely serious, I use my lawnmower. Probably you would not work on lawnmowers, but this is such a simple example. It's a machine, if you turn it on, it's loud and vibrates. So this is perfect to understand the idea of model analysis and all acoustic engineers all about. Okay, so if you understand how we can work on this machine, you can do this on your car, on your aeroplane, or whatever you're working on. Okay, so the first question of course is, what is a mode shape? I heard the word, I listened, but I didn't understand it. Well, just to get your mind right, a mode shape, it's a property of our object. It's a basic fixed property. It's like the color. I would say this is red, okay? This is a property of this lawnmower. It's a red lawnmower. And there's more basic properties, like it has a certain length, 1.5 meter length, and it has a certain weight. Maybe this is 20 kilogram weight. And it has a mode at maybe 100 Hertz. This is fixed to this body. And it doesn't matter what you do with this lawnmower. If you put it on the green and let it work, it has the same color, same length, same weight, and same mode shapes. If you put it in the garage, it doesn't matter. It keeps the same color, same length, and the same mode shapes. And even if you toss it away from an aeroplane and it fall through the air, same color, same length, same weight, same mode shape. It always sticks to the object, okay? It's a property which just is in there, but you can't see it, not yet. And that's why we do model analysis, to see the mode shape. What is a mode shape? Well, a mode shape is, there's a frequency he likes. And if you get this frequency, now what to do with the frequency? Maybe you can see even low frequency, he can swing a little bit in a certain frequency. So to understand, it makes it easier. If you as a human, yeah, this is good. You as a human has also mode shapes. Yeah? I have colors, I have a size, I have weight, and I have mode shapes. For example, if I'm sitting, well, if you've been in Germany, you know there are these big parties, Oktoberfest, yeah? And they're all sitting on this bench, the people, yeah? And nothing happened. But if a certain music comes up with a rhythm, the people start swinging. They do like this, they're singing, yeah? But this is because they have a certain mass and sitting in this kind of chair, and then it can do like this. It just happened by nature, okay? And alcohol, okay. But this is, if the rhythm is right, it doesn't matter which band is playing, just if the rhythm is just fitting through this kind of dance, then they start dancing, because that's the way they put the energy in there, okay? It's a natural behavior with alcohol. But it's just not one mode shape. You can have, if you have a different kind of song, maybe they do that, like something like this, up and down and up. So it's a different motion, same object, different motions. Or if you're in bad luck, maybe most of the time, but sometimes it hits you like this, it's open and getting off. So you are the nut. You could just get hit. So there are different options what to do at which frequency. Important is that the rhythm is close to a perfect mode shape frequency. Okay? It doesn't have to be perfectly right. If the rhythm of the music is a little bit too slow, they still do a little bit like this, but not really high. But it's there. No? But if the rhythm is too fast, a little like this, but only if you go close to the right one, then they catch the frequency, they always will swing in the frequency or the rhythm. But the amplitude is depending on how good you hit the right frequency. This also happens here without music, but we have vibration in there. You know, it's an unbalanced in here. It gets some frequency revolution in here, and at a certain frequency, he can start swinging. And we need to know at which frequencies which mode shape is in there, to understand when this vibration is in there, how we can reduce these big levels of vibration. So that's why we made modal analysis. So now that we know what a mode shape is, we can start with the first step into a modal analysis. Whoa, okay. Well, the first step is defining your measuring points and a suitable coordinate system for these points. Have a think about that. There is your tutorial. You get started very soon. See you.